thank you.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try.
Viewers, it's James Cum, your half-assed reporter, and we're here on the Bowery. We're gonna run into On Stella Rays, and I think on some occasions we don't need any narrative. We'll just let the artwork speak for itself. The performance pieces by Kate Gilmore, and then we'll look at some of the works on paper by Karen Hagel. The artist. Hi, Karen. Thank you. This is James Calm. Here at On Stella Ray's Bowery, and we're looking at Beat by Kate Gilmore and Works on Paper by Karen Hagel.
I hope someday you will join us.
Now we're going to run into Present Company here on Johnson Avenue and look at a show titled Meridian Atlas, featuring work by Claudia Pena Salinas and Lubin Wakoa. Can't think of making it up the stairs. Take a look at Claudia's work first. These are all made with brass, dyed cotton, glass, and various other found objects. This piece is titled Cenote 2017. Brass, dyed cotton, glass owls. Postcards 35 by 49 inches. And so we've got brass rods that she's kind of made into these implied planes. And that's what I was going to say. A lot of this, the way that Claudia is creating her forms, she's using these brass strips to kind of frame space and imply space, contain space, but because they're open, it also allows the space to go back and forth. Also, I like what she's doing. She's got some nice kind of analogous colors here, the maroons, magenta, pinks, and then she's playing this off with kind of found elements, little tchotchkes and things, but they also have color implications. This is titled Popocatalpitl. I don't know whether that's some kind of a Mayan word. This is 62 by 49 by 24 inches. Brass, dyed cotton, water, ceramics, marble. And she's got these postcards and a couple of them. Okay, it's kind of a labial form. I like this piece. We've got a screen of dyed string, and these are all weighted down with river stones. This is 124 by 96 inches. It's titled Aragonite. And then we've got a, it's like mahogany lathe ball. Run through a viewing of the Lubin Wakoa paintings. And these are all oil on linen over panel. This is titled Canyon. Well, Glumman is doing some interesting painting. There are a lot of artists, young painters, that are working on more of a, we would call it, intimate scale. It's titled Modern Dreams. But, Glumman is also kind of riffing on some of the classic modernists. Here we are again. Also, I like this one, Philip Plane. In a sense of the process, this is Wyoming. Yeah, some of these kind of makes me think of Arthur Dove, maybe. You've got kind of sections, but very nice planes of, I guess I would call that a wash. But you also have references to landscape. Dark walks, 12x9. This is a kind of a punchy piece. It's titled Swimming, 11x14. And I've kind of jumped up the color here, but again, it has kind of a, maybe a reference to a pond or a river. Sunset. Small thing. Okay, so this one kind of makes me think of Bassiotis, one of the great New York surrealists. Red Hope. And I like the way Glumman kind of keeps a fresh and spontaneous brushstroke there. It's very loose and spontaneous. There we go. This is a nice color study. It's titled Night. This might be the most maybe obvious reference to a landscape. Almost looks like we've got some mountains there. Maybe a fence post. This is titled Heat. And this is kind of a I call it, it would be an absurd palette, and there's some spray paint in there. And we'll wrap up looking at this little piece. Windshield Meteor. Okay. It's been a little run through of Meridian Atlas, your present company, featuring the work of Claudia Pena Salinas or Salinas, and Glumman Wacoa.
And the world.